Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. We actually had a magnitude 7 earthquake. It was offshore Northern California yesterday, and it is the first magnitude 7 earthquake since August, 17 August. There are well over 100 days in between. And it happened yesterday. And if we look at the planetary geometry, I did an additional update in the social media on the 1st, 2nd of December because of critical geometry with the Moon, Venus and Mars. As I explained in the previous update, Earth was moving between Venus and Mars, and as a result, we had critical lunar geometry with Venus and Mars. And this update on the 1st, 2nd of December, it demonstrates here the geometry, semi-right angle geometry, 45, 135 degrees of the Moon, Venus and Mars. And I specifically said, watch it. And it actually happened a bit later on the 5th. I expected a larger seismic response around the 3rd. It was actually on the 5th. So what is it with Earth between planets and larger earthquakes? Well, if you look at the last 10 years and we look at the largest earthquake so far, is a magnitude 8.3 that was offshore Coquimbo, Chile in September 2015. And guess where Earth was at the time? It was right between Jupiter and Neptune. These two gas giants were on opposite sides of the solar system. Earth was in between, 5 hours away from an exact conjunction. More importantly, on the 16th, the day of the earthquake, before the earthquake occurred, there was semi-right angle geometry of the Moon, Jupiter and Neptune, 45, 135 degrees. It's not the only critical geometry because we always isolate the conjunctions, that's 0 degrees, semi-right angle that is 45, 135 degrees, and right angle that's 90 degrees. And if you want to study this phenomenon, I suggest you look at the year 1906, around 1906, because that was the last time that the outermost planets, Uranus and Neptune, were on opposite sides of the solar system. And whenever Earth got close to that line, we had a big earthquake. 8.8 Ecuador, 7.8 San Francisco, and there were a couple of more big earthquakes in that year. It's very interesting, it's very important to observe. And if you look at the next time frame, on the SGI graph, we are not out of the woods because the exact conjunction with Earth, Venus and Mars will be on the 12th. And we're going to have critical lunar geometry in the coming week as a result. So today, tomorrow, I already explained it in the previous update, we have a convergence of critical planetary geometry, 4 planetary conjunctions. And in the solar system, we see it here today, tomorrow, Sun, Mercury, Earth, Sun, Mercury, Jupiter, Mercury, Venus, Saturn is in there as well, and Sun, Earth, Jupiter. And that all happens today and tomorrow. And there will probably be a seismic response as a result, a typical a higher 5 magnitude earthquake, but it could be a 6-pointer in there as well. Magnitude 7 depends on the stress levels in Earth's crust. We are definitely due because if we look at large earthquakes, 7.8 and larger, the last time was 2 years ago, and normally they occur 2, maybe 3 times a year. And if we look at magnitude 8 and larger earthquakes, the last time was 3.5 years ago. So I already did an update on Facebook as well. Think about this. It's very important. There are probably some fault sections on the planet that are near the tipping point of a big earthquake. So today, tomorrow, convergence of critical planetary geometry. And on the SGI graph, we actually see quite some green labels, and that means the critical lunar geometry. And that's what we have when Earth is between or closely between two planets. And we have planetary conjunctions. That's Earth, Moon, Saturn on the 8th and Earth, Moon, Neptune on the 9th. And there can be a larger seismic response because it is preceded by critical planetary geometry on the 6th, 7th. So following Saturn and Neptune, especially Saturn, there can be a larger earthquake. And we see then on the 8th of December, again, with Venus and Mars, semi-right angle geometry, there is some hours in between. Then we have Sun, Mercury, Mars on the 9th planetary conjunction. And then we have, again, critical lunar geometry. That's going to be a convergence. It's going to be critical. We have semi-right angle geometry with Jupiter and Saturn. Earth is not between them, but the positions of Saturn and Jupiter are such that the Moon makes critical geometry, semi-right angle geometry, and there is not much time actually between them. it's only about 4 hours. And again, that is on the 11th, and it will be immediately followed by right angle, critical right angle geometry, lunar geometry with Venus and Mars. So we have really a convergence of critical lunar geometry on the 11th and 12th. And then we have two planetary conjunctions coming up. That is Venus, Earth, Mars, like I said, and also Mercury, Venus, Neptune. Keep that in mind. This is a near convergence, and Mercury, Venus, Neptune in there, that means there can be a big earthquake following that lunar and planetary geometry. We have then Earth, Moon, Uranus on the 13th, and also Earth, Moon, Jupiter on the 14th towards full moon. So there is the potential there later on in the week for a big earthquake. It could be 7.8 or larger, especially because of this convergence of critical lunar geometry and Venus, Earth, Mars, and Mercury, Venus, Neptune in a near conjunction. Near convergence. So that's the geometry we're going to have in the solar system. We see that on 6-8 December. We had this already, I explained that. And then on the 12th, 13th of December, we see this particular geometry with Earth between Venus and Mars. And we have this right angle geometry, and we also have with the Moon, and we also have Venus and Mercury and Neptune in a conjunction. This is extremely critical geometry, and we're probably not out of the woods. I expect a continuation of a larger, a stronger earthquake, typically a higher 5 magnitude, and there could be 1 or 2 6 points in there, and maybe even a magnitude 7 in a worst case scenario. Following the geometry on the 12th, 13th, there could be, in a worst case scenario, magnitude 8. This is the update for now. Check out the latest updates on our website and in the social media. Also, the atmospheric anomalies, very significant. Stay safe. Until next time.